Well, ciao, buongiorno, benvenuti, welcome to my very, very, very pink apartment. I hope you like pink as much as I do. Today we're having an adventure. We're going from the city of Bari in the region of Puglia. This is the toe of the boot of Italy. We're going to cross that peninsula to the other side of Puglia, to the west side of Puglia. So we're going from east to west, and we're going to the city of Taranto. So we're going from the Adriatic Sea, Bari, to the Ionian Sea in Taranto. Toronto is an interesting town. It's where the Italian Navy is based. But we're going there not because of the Navy, but we are going there because of seafaring traditions. And we're going there to meet a very interesting maker who not only makes things, but he also makes societal change. So come with me, if you will. We're going to start in Bari Centrale, get on the Regionale, and find our way across the peninsula to Taranto. Come with me. It'll be fun.
Allora, io sono un architetto.
Oh, sì, quindi, similar a Francesca.
Come Francesca, esattamente. Sì. Io sono un architetto e ho studiato fuori, non ero a Taranto, io ho studiato a Milano, ho studiato a Roma, mi sono laureato a Roma.
Well, Francesco trained as an architect, but he found that his passion was building and repairing wooden boats.
Ho sempre avuto la passione del mare, facevo, diciamo, sono skipper quando ero più piccolino, poi ho lasciato per andare fuori all'università e gli ultimi anni dei miei studi, anche i primi anni di lavoro, avevo sempre quest'idea di voler fare qualcosa inerente al mare, voler tornare a Taranto e voler mettere su un'attività, un progetto che potesse essere legato al mare in qualche modo.
So, after university, Francesco returned to Toronto. He found a mentor who helped him learn how to build and repair wooden boats, an older gentleman who was one of the last guys still standing, still living, who knows how to do this kind of work. So Francesco was lucky to find this mentor and to acquire some of the tools from this gentleman that he uses in the workshop.
Un nostro vecchio amico maestro d'ascia è un maestro Cataldo si chiama, che è, diciamo, il nostro mentore, okay, sì, il sì. Nostro maestro di quando abbiamo aperto.
Lui è per tuo?
Sì, è il mio, esatto. Sì, sì. Adesso lui ha 95 anni, è molto grande, sì. È ancora lucido, però avendo 95 anni ha smesso di lavorare, quindi mi ha regalato i suoi attrezzi che noi abbiamo esposto qui, perché comunque sono attrezzi antichi.
Some of the different traditional tools that are impossible to find now because they're no longer, you know, manufactured. He started an organization. The organization is called Maremosso. Maremosso. So Maremosso means, if you were to translate it into English, Mare means the ocean, the sea. Mosso would mean choppy or rough. So rough seas or choppy seas is what Maremosso translates to. And he started this organization and was able to secure some funding to kind of preserve the wooden boat building culture, because in Italy, you know, trying to maintain culture is an important thing. It's funded by the government. Can you believe that?
Anche questa è una barca a vela. Queste sono tutte barche a vela. Io costruisco solo barche a vela, non faccio barche a motore, non faccio altro. E principalmente le faccio in legno, cioè principalmente soltanto in legno. Noi non facciamo barche in plastica, in vetro.
Dopo che giocare, coperta da plastica? No,
no, no, no, no, no, non si copre con la, sì. Le barche in legno si lasciano in legno, ah. Quindi vengono semplicemente, viene dato semplicemente la vernice protettiva, la resina, sì, ma sì, la resina sì. non si dà.
Assolutamente, vieni.
Allora, questa è un restauro, non è una costruzione. Questa qui è una barca del 1958 che stiamo restaurando, l'abbiamo recuperata da Trieste, questa qui viene da Trieste,
sì, sì,
e
sì.
Abbiamo iniziato, questo è un restauro, è un lavoro di restauro, praticamente è quasi una ricostruzione, la stiamo quasi tutta ricostruendo, però originariamente è del 58, del 1958.
No.
Sì. Ah, questa dici, il bulbo, questa qui, questa è Ghisa.
Ghisa.
Che serve come contrappeso,
sì, 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 sì,
questo
sì.
È in ghisa e questo qui è questo invece il fasciame che è in legno.
Sì.
Normalmente i bulbi, questi in italiano si chiamano bulbi, erano o in ghisa o in piombo.
Piombo, normalmente in piombo.
Normalmente in piombo, però anche in ghisa perché il piombo è tossico,
sì, sì,
è nocivo,
vero, è vero.
Invece la ghisa no.
And he also received funding for one other purpose, and that was to work with young boys who are in trouble with the law. These young boys come to Maremosso as sort of apprentices, and they are sent by the Italian juvenile court system, and usually a group of five or six young men come at the same time. And work together to build a boat, to get a boat from wood, from raw wood to a finished boat, and then take that boat out and put it in the water and make it sail. It's a wonderful program. I'm really sorry I wasn't there on a day when some of the boys were present, but I really want to thank Francesco for sharing some photos with me of some of his past adventures, some of his past events with these young men.
Barca tipica nostra, del Mar Mediterraneo, è un gozzo a vela.
So when a boat is built at Maremosso, the boat is there's no half model made, there's no CAD drawings made. It's a sketch is made, and then using that sketch, kind of a combination of art and engineering is used to frame out the boat and to build the basic shape of the boat. It's a traditional way of doing it. This is a boat that's currently being constructed by a group of young men assigned to the workshop by the Italian court system.
Sono vari tipi di legno a seconda di quello che è l'uso di cui la barca ha bisogno, si usano vari tipi di legno. Ad esempio, queste che vengono chiamati dritti, il dritto di prua e il dritto di poppa, e la chiglia, che è la parte, diciamo, è come se fosse la spina dorsale della barca, sono in rovere, quercia,
oak. Oak, sì, sì.
Mentre le costole, che dovrebbero essere, in inglese dovrebbe essere frame.
Sì, the frame, yes.
Okay? Le costole sono invece in materiale vario, principalmente in frassino. Il frassino è un legname locale, insomma, è un legname europeo del Mediterraneo del Sud, ma sono anche in modano e anche in rovere, in quercia, a seconda di quello che è il materiale a disposizione. Si usano legnami duri per fare la parte strutturale.
So while I try hard, my Italian is not so great. And luckily, while I was there, while I was visiting with Francesco at Maremosso, the next door neighbor stopped by, Lavinia, who is a video editor herself, and maybe we'll learn more about her her business in a future video. But she stopped by and was nice enough to ask a few of the nuanced questions that I was trying to get answers to that were beyond my ability to speak Italian.
Lavinia, grazie, Lavinia. Italian, you know, the last 2 years have been very difficult for many organizations because of COVID. And how did he survive his organization during COVID?
Come hai reagito a questi due anni di COVID? Come hai fatto a sopravvivere in questo periodo?
Vabbè, per noi, diciamo, il COVID non è stato molto complicato, perché fortunatamente avevamo dei progetti che...
He says it wasn't that difficult because it's just him and his collaborator. Mm-hmm. So it's not a place open to public.
Sì, sì, sì.
So you can...
He was able to work here. Yeah, and there wasn't a problem with...
Yeah, because there wasn't clients or other people.
But of course, the children couldn't come then.
No.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Lavinia, for bailing me out at the end when I was trying to ask a question about COVID and how it worked. It turned out that it was not a problem for him. He just couldn't have the kids in, but he was able to continue to do his work because he was just working by himself or with one collaborator, and it wasn't a problem in Taranto for him. So thank you, Lavinia. Thank you, Francesco, for spending the time with me and for opening up your beautiful officina to me, your beautiful workshop. And also thanks to my friend Francesca from Firenze, who was kind enough to point me in the direction of Francesco and help me make the arrangements to come and visit and do this quick video. Well, that's it for this this visit to Taranto. Yeah, I got back on the train and went back to Bari that afternoon, and after having a little bit of food there in Taranto, but it was a fantastic trip. It's always wonderful to find people who are passionate about what they're doing, and especially people who are trying to preserve the old ways. Well, if you'd like to see more of this, let me know. If you have questions, comments, concerns, whatever, put them down below, and be in touch. If this is useful to you and you want to see more, please subscribe, please give it a thumbs up, please hit the notification bell and all that kind of stuff so I'll know you're listening. Anyway, from today from the city of Bologna, where I'm currently working on this video, I hope that the life is good for you, and I hope that you get to come and visit this wonderful country of Italy one day soon. I'll be looking forward to hearing about your adventures too. Ciao.